Hi guys, it's Lori. Wow, it's been a long time, huh? Really long time. But I watched Neely's tag video today, and I was one of them that she actually called out at the end, so I was like, aw, she's so sweet. So I thought, okay, I'll do it today. I'm doing it today. All right, so I have the questions all printed out right here. Let's just dive right into it. Name. My name's Lori. Fluffy Nomo, Fluff, Fluffy, Fluffmeister. I'll answer just about anything. And have you started your holiday shopping yet? Well, yeah, I have. Now it's December 12th, so back when she put the tag out originally, probably would have said no, not yet. But yes, I've definitely started my shopping, mostly online. That's the way I like to do it. So are you a Black Friday shopper? God, no. I hate Black Friday shopping. I really do. I don't like to shop anyways, and ugh. No, it's terrible. I hate it. Way too crowded. Crazy. No, not worth it to me at all. As frugal as I am, I do not Black Friday shop. Rather slam my head in a car door, to be honest. So, yeah. No, I don't. Fake or real tree? I love a real tree. All that just smells so good and just so natural and just, I love it. Love a real tree. But we have a fake one. Yeah. Anyway, multicolored or white lights? Multicolored for sure. This year I have the big fat lights on there. We kind of alternate between the big fat lights and the little mini lights or whatever you call them. And it takes me a long time to do the mini lights because I string them through each branch, like wrap them around every branch and put the branch on, and it's just loaded with lights that way. And like when you stand there and look at it and you kind of move back and forth, it's like it just twinkles and so pretty. But it's very time consuming. So this year I decided to go with the easy one and just did the big fat lights. You just clip them on and go, you know. Anyway, multicolored for sure. I put my tree up sometime, I don't know, week after Thanksgiving, sometime in there. Just, it's always after Thanksgiving though, for sure. Have to eat my turkey first. What holiday craft do you enjoy the best? I don't do holiday crafts. December is such a busy time for me. I have extra houses to clean and just so much work to do extra. It's worth my job. And, you know, it's just a busy time anyway. So I don't do any crafts at holiday time. But when my kids were littler, I used to do with them, we'd always save toilet paper rolls and the empty rolls, you know, we take a bunch of those and just save them. And we get out those and construction paper and glue and tape and markers and the little googly eyes and cotton and just, you know, just a bunch of different odds and end things. And they would make, you know, they cover them with the construction paper and make snowmen and Santa Clauses and angels and all kinds of soldiers, you know, stuff like that. Yeah, I have a bunch of those saved in a box somewhere. I don't set them all out every year, but, you know, something I can't throw away, one of those things. So anyway, where am I at here? Hot chocolate or eggnog? Eggnog. Yeah, I like hot chocolate. It's all right. Eh, whatever, you know. Kids like hot chocolate. They don't like eggnog, but I do. My daughters like eggnog, too. Of course, we put Captain Morgan in it, so that probably helps. But anyway, not in all of it. We just put it in the fridge, and then we add some Captain Morgan to ours. So. Favorite holiday tradition from your childhood? That would have to be the Christmas Eve candlelight service at church. My mom always took me to that. We'd meet my grandparents there, my aunt. It was just something special that I remember from my childhood. My dad never went. He was not a church goer, so he never went. We really only went as a family like that on Christmas Eve, and it's just something I always remember. Another thing that's not really from my childhood, but it's from years ago, would be that some local charities would sell luminarias, the kits to make them, with the paper bags and the sand and the candles and stuff. And they would sell those kits to buy food for holiday food boxes for the needy. And that was the thing that, like, I live in a really small town, and like everybody in town would buy these luminarias, these kits. And then the thing was, on Christmas Eve, right at dusk, everybody was supposed to go outside and put these luminarias out and light the candles. And then as soon as it got dark out, you know, you could drive around or whatever. And I cannot stop coughing. This video is going to be all chopped up because I cannot stop having coughing attacks. I probably look like I'm crying because don't know what the deal is, but I don't know. I can't stop coughing. Where was I? Oh yeah. Christmas Eve after dark, you light the set up luminaries and light them, and then you can go drive through town, and I mean everybody's got luminaries lining their sidewalks, and it was just really cool because since there was a certain time you were supposed to do it, like the whole neighborhood would be out at the same time doing it. And we'd help each other, and you know, the one year it was like really super windy and we were all getting together and helping each other, holding the bags and filling it with sand and going and getting stones and rocks and everything else to put them because it was so windy. By the time you got one set up, you know, everything else is blowing away. And it's like, but, you know, it's just something that we did every year. And it was just, I don't know, it was just a community closeness thing or whatever. But anyway, that was pretty cool. Favorite Christmas cookie? That would have to be, it's not really a Christmas cookie, I guess, but my grandma's buttermilk cookies. My mom and I both make those. Favorite dish from the holidays, excluding dessert? Well, besides the honey-glazed spiral ham, that's good stuff. It would have to be my mom's homemade stuffing. Yep. She makes it with no turkey guts. I hate turkey guts. And let's see, what's the next thing? Favorite dessert from the holidays? Was that next? Oh, yeah. Favorite dessert from the holidays. That would probably be Cherry Delight. Or my grandma's, she called it green salad. I don't know if that's really what you call it, but it was bad. I don't have the recipe for it, but I'm going to have to get it. My mom probably has it. It was like green jello and cream cheese and marshmallows, and I don't know what was all in it, but it was good. Favorite holiday song or album? You can hear it playing in the background right now. The Time Life Treasury of Christmas. It's a two-disc set, and I've had it for years, and I love it. In fact, I don't remember what happened to one of them once. It broke it or something. I don't know what happened to it, but I ordered a new one right away. Thank God they still had them because I'd had them for years, and a couple years ago I had to get a new one because of that. So, The Time Life Treasury of Christmas. Love it. It's the best. Favorite song on it is probably Christmas in Dixie. I really like that song. I don't know. I like so many of them, though. But I really like Christmas in Dixie. Candy canes. Nah. I don't really like candy canes. Like a couple other people said, you know, if they're crushed up on peppermint bark or something like that, that's okay. But to eat a candy cane, you probably never see me eat a candy cane. If I'm going to eat sugar, it's not going to be wasted on a candy cane. Favorite gift that you've received? That's easy. My engagement ring. Christmas morning, the year John gave me my engagement ring. We got up and we could hear the kids starting to get up, so we went in the other room, just the two of us, and he proposed and gave me my engagement ring. So that has to top any other present, I think. Pretty sure. Okay. Favorite gift that you've given? That's a tough one because, you know, the giving part's my favorite, so it'd have to be when a friend of mine. Me and a friend of mine, she was a coworker at the time, we went together and delivered to two families. We delivered, she had an SUV and we had it filled up with presents and food. And we delivered that to two families that had nothing. So that had to be the best. That was really emotional. It was pretty cool. I liked it a lot. It made me feel really good. We wore Santa hats too. Okay, what's on your Christmas wish list this year? I have an Amazon wish list, so there's a lot of little things on there. I have simple little things, I guess, like nothing major or fancy, just sheets. I need some new sheets for my bed and some accessories for my phone that I want. Well, there's a lot of stuff on there for after the first of the year. I'm going to start selling on Amazon, and I need some supplies to get started on that, so I put that on my wish list, some things for that, and I can't really think of anything else that's on there. I know there's a few other little things, but yeah, nothing major. Any fun holiday plans? No, just same old, same old. But that's, you know, the simple things, that's what we like, so yeah, just Christmas Eve, we'll get Chinese and watch Christmas Story and wrap presents all night long and after the kids go to bed and sleep for about an hour or two and get back up. That's how it usually works out. We say we're not going to do that this year, but we always do. So. And of course, we drive around, you know, a couple take a couple evenings after dark and drive around and look at the Christmas lights and, you know, just we'll take an evening and sit down and we'll probably, John and I'll probably have like a glass of wine or two and just watch, I don't know, some Christmas movie. There's a few different ones we like. Like Christmas Eve, like I said, we watched A Christmas Story, but then while we're wrapping gifts every year, tradition, can't break it. We watch It's a Wonderful Life. And I have it in color. I prefer black and white though. I like that original stuff. But anyway, yeah, that's about it. We're pretty easy to please. Nothing fancy. Pretty simple. Just the way we like it. Okay, so I cannot stop coughing. My eyes are like, I don't know what's going on. I think I'm getting sick right here in front of you. You're witnessing it live. Oh, gosh. Anyway, yeah, I guess that's about it. I need to do an update. Really bad. I'll do that one of these days. Soon? Okay. That's it for now. See ya.